Linear algebra lecture 7 on theorems and problems of linear span. Beta topic hum log head department of mathematics MBS Government Arts Science College Mahabubnagar. Yesterday already we discussed about the linear span, linear combination. Today I am going to discuss about the theorems of linear span and some problems of linear span. Yesterday also we have proved some theorems and problems of linear span. So now I am going to discuss some other theorems and some other problems of linear span. So problem: determine if the set H of all matrices of the form A, B, O, 0, D is subspace of M2 class 2. Determine all the elements of the all problem of the form this A, B, 0, D is subspace of M2 class 2. And take that let M2 class 2 over R is a vector space. Right? That. This what is M2 class 2? I want to explain that. What is M2 class 2? So M2 class 2 nothing but this is M2 class 2, the matrix. So M2 class 2 equal to how it is the form, the set of all matrices of the form, you take that A, B, C, D, this is 2x2 matrix. Such that here I am taking that these elements are belongs to R, that's why I am writing here M2 plus 4R. Thus is A, B, C, so D belonging to my real number. This belonging to my real number. Is M2 class 2 over. Instead of writing this, so you may write like this also. This matrix written as A, I, J of 2x2 matrix. Such that A, I, J belonging to R. Here I take from 1 to 2, J takes from 1 to 2. That means so the matrices look like A11, A12, A21, A22. This is my matrix. So this can also will take. This is my M2 cross vector space. Already we proved that this is vector space. So this is a E is a vector space. So, in lecture 1 and 2, already I proved that these are the vector space. This is my vector space. What E has could show that the set of all matrices of the form H has given that set of all matrices of the form. So he asked me to find that A, so this my matrix is A, B, 0, some D, such that A comma, B comma, D comma belonging to R. So I want to find that this right so this is subspace of M2. I want to show that H is subspace of this M2 class 4. So I am taking that the elements of which I am taking that let so A, B, 0, D, so is belong into H. I am taking this element. So considering, I am considering that, consider so what I am taking here, this A, I am taking this A, B, 0, D. I am taking down of A. So then what happens is here 1, 0. So first of all, what you write here, simply I am not taken out of this matrix written as so A 0 0 0 plus okay, so plus 0 D, sorry, this is B 0 and 0. Next I am writing this is plus, yeah, I am writing here 0 0 0. If I add this thing, we will get this matrix only. If I add these three elements, we'll get three matrices, we'll get this matrix, right? So from this I am taking common out A here. If I take A common out, then what happen? One, zero, zero, zero. So if I take B common out, so 0, 1, 0, 0. If I take D common out, what happens if I take D common out? 0, 0, 0, 1. So that means, so these 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1 are the element of vector space V. This is our 2 by 2 matrix, right? This element belongs to F. That means, so this is called, I am writing here, this is span of, this element, right, 1, 0, 0, 0, next comma, span of, how to write here, 0, 1, 0, 0, next span of, 0, 0, 0, 1. So these are vectors in M2 class 2. So we can write here it is span of some V1, V2, V3. So that means this H equal, this element belongs to H, that's why H is equal to span of V1, V2, V3. H is equal to span of V1, V2, V3 by spanning set theorem. We say that already yesterday we proved that span of V1, comma V2, comma data as Vn or the elements of vector space. Then it is span of V1, V2, V3 also subspace of V over F. Yesterday already proved that if V over F is a vector space and V1 comma V2 comma dash as I am writing here Vn or belonging to V, then so span of V1, V2, dash, 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 Vn is okay, is subspace of V over F. This thing yesterday already I proved theorem. That's why H is equal to span of V1, V2, V3 is subspace of M2 cross 2 over F, right? So this is proved the problem. This thing we have to explain, right? Here quickly I am explaining that H is equal to AB0D that equal to A times of every place adding this. Next time I came out A come out and B come out, D come out. That is a linear combination of this and this and this linear combination of this element. That equal to span of this thing is a space of M2 plus 2 by span theorem. That therefore H is a space of M2 plus 2 over R. Okay, the set of all continuous real valued functions defined continuous real valued functions defined on closed A comma B in R is denoted by C over A comma B comma. A comma B. This set is subspace of vector space of real valued functions defined on A comma B. Show that F in C such that F of A equal to F of B is subspace of C over A comma B. So it's very important that set of all continuous real valued function defined on C is in R is denoted by C of A. So set of all continuous, if you take that, it is denoted by A. The set is a space of real valued functions defined on C such that I'm taking that F equal to C A comma such that F of A equal to F of B is a space of C over. So I want to show this is a space of C over A comma B, right? C of A comma B is set of continuous function. My set is V is equal to F of X such that F A comma B is a continuous function. This is my vector space. H is equal to, I'm taking that F of C equal to A comma is that F of A equal to, this is vector space and this is right. I want to check that this H is subspace of A. If I'm taking that, let F comma G belong to H. That means if F is belong to H, it must satisfy the relation F of A equal to F of A. If G belongs to H, it must satisfy this relation G of A equal to G of B. Consider PF plus QG of A equal to PF of A plus QG of B. I'm considering this, right? PF of A plus QG of A. I'm taking out this iterator like this. Because these are belonging to vector space, we have set space, all 10 properties. Out of 10 properties, I'm taking that distributive property, right? So PF of B here and QF of B. F of A nothing but F of B, right? F of B. QG G of B. So that equal to QG of B and G of B. So QG G of B. F of PF QG of A equal to PF plus GQ of B. So therefore, the elements in this set satisfy the relation F of A equal to F of B. So we say that this element belongs to H. I am taking that PA plus QG belongs to, so I am considering this set of A. I show that PA plus QG of A equal to PA plus QG of B. So both are same. That means this element belonging to H. For all F comma G belongs to H. And P comma B belongs to R. Therefore, H is subspace of V. H is a subspace of V according to subspace theorem. Suppose U1 comma U2 comma data as UP and V1 comma V2 comma data as VQ or vectors. In vector space V, let H is equal to span U1, U2, data VP and K is equal to span V1, V2, data VQ. Show that H plus K is equal to span of U1, comma U2, comma data UP. I want to show that this, right? So, let I am taking that U1, comma U2, comma data UP and V1, comma V2, comma data VQ are vectors in vector space V over if I am taking like this. He asked me that H is equal to span of this thing and K is equal to span of this thing. He is given. H is equal to span of U1, U2 dash UP. K is equal to span of V1, V2 dash VQ. H plus K is equal to U plus V such that sum of two subspaces already explained in lecture subspaces, right? Sum of two linear sum of two subspaces that equal to H plus K equal to U plus V such that U belongs to H and V belongs to K. A belongs to H, but If I take any element O, sorry, if I take any element in this set O, so that means O, if I take any element, it is a linear combination of these elements. If I take that O, U belongs to H O, which implies it is the linear combination of these vectors. That means if I take any R, U belongs to H, U is a linear combination of this element, that will be AU1, AU2, AU2. So if I take V here, so V is equal to this. This is V equal to V1 plus V2 plus V2. It is in the form like this. I am going to U plus V. U nothing but AV1 plus AV2 plus dash dash AP1 plus V nothing but BV1 plus BV2 plus dash dash BV2. So it's nothing but it is this A1, A2 dash are filled to you can write it easily that AV1 plus AV2 plus AV plus BV1 plus BV2 plus dash BV. These AIs and BIs all belong to F. That means it is a linear combination of U1, U2, UP dash dash V1, V2. UP plus V1, V2, comma, as we go. So that means it is a linear combination of these elements. It's nothing but U plus belonging to span of U1, comma, U2, comma, UN, VV, and V1, comma, V2. Therefore, U plus V is equal to H. U plus V is belonging to H plus K. So therefore, U plus V, therefore, U plus V belongs to H plus K, which implies what can I take that? What I show here? U plus V belongs to span of U1 comma U2, right? First part is over. H plus K is also equal to span of V1 comma dot as UP, V1 comma V2 comma dot as VQ. I show on this part. I want to show that H plus K is equal to span of U1 U2, right? First part I show. I have an element here. I show that element belongs to this set. I show that U plus V belongs to H plus K. It is in span of this set. I shown. Now I am taking that an element x in span of u1 comma u2 comma data up v1 comma v2 comma data as vq. I took some element in this set. I want to show that this element in right. So I want to show that this element in h plus k. If I take that x is equal to span of this element, that means it is a linear combination of elements, these things. That means x is a linear combination of u1, u2, up, v1, v2, vq. X is equal to, how to write here? a1, u1 plus u2, u2 plus da-da-da, ap, up plus b1, v1 plus b2, v2 plus da-da as bp, vp. bq, vq. We'll take like this. bq, vq. So that means x belongs to u plus v, x plus x is equal to this is u, this is v. That means x is equal to u plus v. This element belongs to h plus k. Therefore, if I take x is in the span of this set, I show that x is in h plus k. Therefore, span of that means we got what to show here. Span of u1 comma u2 comma data gp is also equal to h plus k. So this is 2. Consider this is 2. From 1 and 2, what happens? Span of u1 comma u2 comma data gp, v1 comma v2 comma data vq is equal to h plus k. This is n square root 0. Determine problem. I want to show other problem. Determine if y in the subspace of R4 spanned by the columns of A, where A is equal to this matrix 3, minus 5, minus 9, 8, 7, minus 6, minus 5, minus 8, 3, 2, minus 2, minus 9, comma Y is equal to minus 4, minus 8, 6, minus 5. If I take like this, A, this is 5. Determine if Y is the subspace of R4 spanned by the columns of this matrix. Okay, so this I want to show that y equal to this minus 4, minus 8, minus 6, right? A is equal to this matrix. This is v1, v2, v3. I am writing here where v1 is equal to in the form of this mono of v1, v2. V1 nothing but this row and v this column, and v2 nothing but this column, v2 nothing this column. Consider I am considering it y is equal to a1, v1 plus a2, v2 plus a2. This is y. minus 4, minus 8, 6, minus 5. A1 nothing but A1 only, V1 nothing but this is the column, A2 nothing but A2, and V2 nothing but this column, A3 nothing but A3, this column. Right? If I multiply, you will get here 3A1, 8A1, minus 5A1, 2A1. If I multiply this, minus 5A2, 7A2, 8A3. If I multiply this, 9A3, minus 9A3, minus 6A3, 3A3, minus 9A3. Right? If I add these columns of the matrices, what do you get here? 3A1 minus 5A2 minus 9A3. Similarly, you can have these all columns. Right? 3A1 minus 5A2 minus 9A3, 8A1 plus 7A2 minus 6A3. Right? So, the two matrices are equal, that's why I am equaling the elements of the two columns of the matrix right here. This column equal to this, 3A1 minus 5A2 minus 9A3 equal to 4. And 8A1, 7A2 equal to this, and this equal to 6, and this equal to this. Here I've got four equations. So now I'm going to solve these four equations. I'm going to solve these four equations. So first of all, what I do here 9 is there, that's why I'm writing here 1 minus 4. If I do 1 minus 4, I will get A1 minus 3A2 equal to 1 plus 1. If I do 2 plus 2 into 3 is equal to, what will get here, minus 2A1 minus 9A2 plus 4. Right? If I do 2 into 5 plus 6, so you will get that other equation. So A2 equal to this. So, and A2 equal to, the final value is minus 2 by 5. If I substitute this value, so are there any other equations which contain in 6 or I think, we will get A1 equal to this thing. A1 equal to also minus 2 by 5. So similarly, you can substitute this value. So there we will get A3 equal to 3 by 4. Similarly, we will get other things that, okay. So this value, you can substitute any other equation which is not involved in this. Okay. So that means what we do here, we have to solve A1, A2, A3 by using any of these three equations. So I used here 1, 4, 3. 2, 3. Okay, no problem. 1, 4, 2, 3 I used, right? Okay, by involving all equations, I want to find A1, A2, A3. So by solving these four equations, I got that A1 equal to minus 1 by 5, A2 is equal to minus 2 by 5, A3 is equal to 3 by 5. So that means this minus 4, 8, 6 equal to minus 1 by this thing plus minus 2 by this thing plus 3 by 5, right? A1 equal to A1, A2 equal to A3 equal to this value. So we will get to satisfy this relation. Therefore, this is y, right? Y is a linear combination of V1, V2, V3. Therefore, y is in subspace of R4. So we have shown that y is linear combination of this thing. Therefore, y is subspace of R4. Show that W is in the subspace of R4 spanned by V1, V2, V3, where W is equal to this and V1 equal to V2 equal to this. Same problem, I am going to explain quickly. This is my W, this is V1, V2, V3. What I am doing here, W is equal to AV1 plus AV2, V2 plus A3, V3. I am taking this. If I simplify, we will get 4 equations, 1, 2, 3, 4 equations. By solving these 1, 2, 3, 4 equations, so can solve anything. So easily you can do that. You can solve 1, 2, 3 equations, or you can solve 2, 3, 4 equations, or you can solve any of three equations. Find A1, A2, A3, then substitute another equation which is not involved in this equation. Suppose if I solve 1, 2, 3, by solving 1, 2, 3, if I get A1, A2, A3, that values we have to substitute in 4. If it satisfies the condition, so the values in this case 4, then only it is spanned, otherwise it is not spanned. So that's why here what I am taking that, I am going to solve these equations. So here 1, 2, 3 I am solving here. So 3 into 1 equal to 8 into 3. So we will get this equation 3 into 3 minus 4. If I do 9, 8, okay, this is 4. 3 into 3 minus 9, 4 involving 4. 4 into 1 minus 18 into 2. If I do minus thing, subtracting here, This is fourth equation. We'll get this equation. So 3 into 1 and 8 into 3, if I do that, we'll get this equation. 4 into 1 minus 8 into, we'll get other equations. By using these, if I get that 3 into 1 is equal to 8 into 3, if I solve this equation, we'll get. Similarly, what you do, whatever may be, this is nothing will happen, but we can solve by using your own idea. By using your own idea. So why? Because otherwise it is not able to, if I solve this equation, so what I get here, 2a2 plus 5a3 equal to 1. So we get a3 equal to 1, and from this, so a2 equal to minus 2, we will get a1 equal to also 1. So that means, therefore this vector is equal to 1 times of 8 minus 4, 3 minus 3, 9, 2 times of, that means, so you can do that, this is a linear combination of v1, v2, v3, w is the span of R4, right? So this kind of problems already we solved that. If it is generated by this thing, then we say that it is a linear span, this element belongs to linear span, otherwise it not belong to linear span. Suppose simply I will going to explain that one example to you. Here I am taking that, suppose R2 I am taking, right? R2, okay, so R2 over R is a vector space, my vector space. How do you say here? R2 over R is my vector space. Oh, I am taking that one element. So 1 comma 2. Is linear combination of 1, 0, 0 comma 1. Show that this is a span of subspace by these vectors. Okay. So this is, you can take that y here, this is v1, v2. Show that this is the span of these vectors in R2 or R. That means, subspace generated by this, right? Show that this vector is subspace generated by this. That means, y can be written as simply you can use here, easy task here. So 1 times of 1, 0. Plus 2 times of 0 comma 1. 2 times of 0 comma 1. So that means this is a, so y nothing but this, right, 1 comma 2. If I want to do, if I multiply, we'll add it. 1 0 plus 0 2. That means if I add, you will get this vector only. That's why I am saying that y is belonging to span of span of 1, 0, 0, 1. Y belong to span of 1, 0, 0. Which means y belong into span of v1, v2. So that means y is in subspace generated by v1 comma v2 in R2 or R, right? If it is, I would like to write that. This show that I want to take another problem here. Show that this 1 comma 2, same R2 R vector space problem here, R2 over R is the vector space. So I want to explain that we have to understand what is the concept is happening here. Which concept is happening, right? This R2R is vector space. I am here explaining that. Show that this 1 comma 2 is not is not a subspace generated by 1, 1, 2, 2. One comma one, two comma two. That means we have to show that this is not in span of. That means this y. Yeah. So this is y. This is v one. This is v two. So that means we have to show that y is not in span of. V1 comma V2. I want to show that this is not in this set. So this idea, if it is there that y is subspace, if show that if I some problem already we just now discussed that we have shown that a vector is generated is in subspace generated by some vectors has given. Now I am showing that here this vector is not in span of this matrix, this generated by this vector, subspace generated by this vector, right? So that means, so how do we consider that? So for this, I want to consider y is equal to a1 v1 plus a2 v2. So I'm considering this y comma a1 a2, right? Right, so what is a1? A1 is nothing but a1, v1 nothing but 1, 1, a2 nothing but a2, what is v2? 2, 2. What is y? Y is equal to, I am taking that 1, 2. So this thing already I know that y is 1 comma 2. If I adding a separate this sectors, then what will get here? So that equal to 1 comma 2 equal to 1 comma 2 equal to what I get here? A1 plus A2 A2, 2 times, right? That's why 2A2. If I add this left hand side is 1 comma 2, right hand side is A1 plus 2A2. Here A1 plus 2A2. Which implies what happened here? Which implies A1 plus 2A2 equal to 1. This is 1, equation 1, you can take that, this is equation 1. A1 plus 2A2 equal to, this is equation 2. So for what values of a1 a2 which are satisfy these two equation, right? A1 plus 2 equal to a1 and a1 plus 2 a2 equal to 2. It is very difficult, right? It is very difficult to say that. Why? Because left hand side is the same value, a1 plus 2 a2 a1 plus 2 a2, but right hand side is 1 comma 2. If I substitute any value, they are not satisfied these two equations. So if I take that a2 equal to 0, a1 equal to 1, I will get here 1. But this 1 comma 0 not satisfy the relation. 1 plus 2, 0, that equal to 2. Not satisfied, right? If I take that a1 equal to here, a1 equal to 0, a2 equal to 1, not equal to 2, not equal to. It does value satisfy this equation. That means we are unable to find any a1 comma a2. Therefore, we say that, so y is not span of this element. We are unable to a1, a2, therefore there do not exist any a1, a2, is that 1 comma 2 is equal to a1 equal to 1 plus a2 equal to 2 comma. Therefore, y is not in span of v1 comma v2. So that's why you say that this is not in span of this set. Like that, we have to understood which case we have in span of that element, which is not that element does not belong into span of that vectors. Right? This thing we have to remember. The vector space H is equal to span of 1, cos 4t, cos 4c is continuous. It contains at least two intersecting functions that will be f of t is equal to this and g of t is equal to this expression. Study the graph of f for 0 less than 2t less than 2π and guess simple formula for f of t and g and repeat for g of t. The vector space H is equal to this given contains at least two intersecting functions, so that will be f of t and g of t. Sorry, interesting functions. We have to show that this contains at least two interesting functions, so that will be this and g of t. So that means what can I show here? I want to show that this is a linear combination of this element. If I show that. And also similarly, this is a linear combination of this element. We can easily show that if it is show that this is contains this vector and this has contains this vector. Now we have to verify the graph of this function, right? Taking that it is equal to span of 1 cos 4t, cos 4t, cos 4t. This is a vector space, right? Cos 2t is written as cos square 2 cos 4t to minus 1. Cos 4t is written as cos 2 into 2t is equal to 2 cos 4t to 2 theta minus 1. Cos 4t is equal to written as 2 times of cos 2t, nothing but 2 cos 4t to minus, that equal to 2 cos square t minus 1 whole square, that equal to minus 1. That equal to what we get here, cos 4t is equal to 8 cos 4t minus 8 cos square t square 2 plus 2 minus 1. That equal to cos 4t is equal to simply by implementing here 1 plus 8 cos 4t theta minus 8 cos square theta. Therefore, f of t is equal to 1 8 to cos 4t. Minus 8 cos 4t that equal to cos 4t. So this is f of t equal to what is this is 1 minus 8 cos 4t plus 8 cos 4t. 1 minus 8 cos 4t is f of t nothing but cos 4t. So here we write here this cos 4t that equal to this. That means e1 belonging to 1 cos 1 cos span of this set. Cos 4t also this, cos 4t also. That means this may be written as span of f of t equal to I will write letter span of 1 and span of cos square theta, cos 4 theta, and cos theta. If it is here 0 cos 4 theta, that means f of t is span of that element. F of t is equal to span of that element. See, this is a linear combination of, if I write here 0 times of cos 4 60, cos 4 of 60, cos 4 60, cos 4 of 60, that means it is the span of 1 cos 40, cos 40, that means this is element in span. So that means I say that this is containing. I want to draw a graph for this. Cos 40 is equal to, right? Cos 4t is equal to, you can substitute to 0, cos 0 equal to 1. You substitute to 5 by 12, that equal to how much here, you get this value, 1 by 2, and 5 by 8, you can substitute 0. Similarly, 5 by 6 will minus 1 by 2, 5 by 4 will get to 1 by 2. At 5 by 4, what happened? Cos 5 equal to minus 1. Cos 5 minus 1 will get similarly. So the graph is looking same, look like this. The graph shape is looking like this. That means it goes to like this. Right? Similarly, it goes to at pi by minus pi by equal to 0 and pi by 4 equal to 1, pi by 12 equal to, sorry, 0 equal to 1 and pi by 4 equal to minus 1. Similarly, we will get this, the graph shape is look like this only, but the values are this. That means it is look like shrinking, right? G of t is equal to, if I take that, minus 1 plus cos 8 to the right. Cos 60 is equal to, right, cos 2 into 3t, that equal to 2 cos square 3t minus 1. I know that 2 cos 3t, cos 3t equal to minus 1, that is equal to 2 cos 3 minus 4 cos square theta. Cos 3 by 3 cos 3 minus 4 cos square theta into minus 1. If I multiply these two elements, what will get here? 2 times of 3 cos t minus 4 cos square t plus 3 cos t, that equal to, will get 9 cos square t minus 12 cos square t minus 12 cos square t. If I multiply, we will get this expression, right? 3 into 3 equal to 9 cos square t, 3 into 4 is equal to minus 12 cos 4 t, and 3 into 4 equal to minus 12 cos 4 t, and 4 into 4 equal to 16 minus 3 minus plus 16 cos 4 60 minus 1. That equal to 18 cos 40 minus 24 cos 40 minus 24 cos 40 plus 32 cos 460. So that equal to written as minus 1 plus 18 cos 40 minus 48 cos 40 plus 32 6 cos 40. That means, so g of t equal to cos 60, that is equal to, that means, so it is a span of 1 cos 40 cos 40 cos 460. That means, so this is an interesting function in span of this element 1 cos 40, this cos 40 is correct. So that means, so g of t is contained in h. We shown that the graph of this cos 60 is equal to, like same only, cos 0 is equal to 1, cos pi by 2 equal to 0, and cos pi by equal to minus 1 by root 2, cos pi by is equal to minus 1, and cos pi by 4 equal to 0. So look like the shape of the graph is same, but the values is different. Okay, here pi by 6 equal to minus 1, there I will get that pi by 4 equal to minus 1. Here 5 by 6 only will get this. That means the graph is shrinking like this. Okay, so graph is graph of this is looking like it goes to 0. Okay, it looking over here, the shape is, so that thing, that's why we have written the graphs of cos 60. This is cos 60. Okay, theorem. Let V over A be a vector space. Let V over F be a vector space. S is subspace of V over F if and only if L of S is equal to S. L of S is equal to S. S is subspace of V over F, then if and only if L of S is equal to S. Right? Second one, L of S is equal to S. L of S is equal to S. Okay. Let I am taking that V over A be a vector space. V over A be a vector space. Let S be a subspace of V over F. S be a subspace of V over F. S is equal to, I am writing here, V1, V2, V3, add V, subspace of V. That is L of S nothing but, what is L of S? Set up all possible linear combination of elements of S, right? That equal to gamma summation AI UI. Is that AI belongs to F? That means gamma belongs to L of S. If I take any gamma belongs to F, it is in the form of linear combination of elements of this. That's why gamma is equal to A1 V1. Okay, this is S is equal to V1 V2. This is also V1 here. So gamma is equal to A1 V1 plus A2 V2 plus AN VN belongs to L of S. Therefore, S is subspace of B. S is subspace of B, which implies AI belongs to F. V I belongs to S, which implies A I is comma V I belongs to S, since S is subspace of S. So A I V I belongs to S, that means A1 V1 belongs to S, so A2 belongs to S, so that has A N V N belongs to S, which implies what can I write here? A1 V1 plus A2 V2 plus A N V N belongs to S. Why? Because S is subspace, that means it satisfies closure property. A1 A2 A2 A3 A3 that has A N V N belongs to S, which implies this element belongs to S, which is nothing but gamma belongs to S. Gamma belongs, therefore what happened? Gamma belongs to L of S. I take that gamma belongs to L of S, which implies gamma belongs to S. Therefore, L of S is equal to S. Again, I am taking that let X belongs to S. Let X belongs to S, which implies X equal to 1 into X. X equal to 1 into X. So, X is S. That means it is a linear combination of vectors of S. It is a linear combination of vectors of S. X belongs to S. If I take x into 1, that means it will length of x. That means x belongs to L of s. Therefore, x belongs to s, which implies x belongs to L of s. This is true. From 1 and 2, what relation is that? L of s is of hyperbole. So, this, therefore, s is of equal to L of s. S is of equal to L of s. This is true. From L of s of hyperbole 1, L of s is equal to, from 1 and 2, what I am writing here, L of s is equal to s. Therefore, L of S is equal to S. L of S is subspace of U over F. Why? Because S subspace of U over F, then L of S subspace of U over F. Which implies S is equal to, I am taking the L of S is subspace of U over F. Now I am taking that S is subspace of L of right? Therefore, S is subspace of U over F. So, for this one condition is over, right? Subspace of U over F, then L of S is equal to F. I prove that if I take L of S equal to S, its subspace of S is clearly. So, first condition over. So, second one, L of S is equal to S. I know that S is equal to L of S. That equal to what happened? L of S is equal to L of S. L of S is what? S. Therefore, L of S is equal to S. Right. So, second theorem is also proved. Right. So, I have taken that to S is subspace of U over. I have shown that L of S is equal to S. Now, I am taking that L of S is equal to S. I want to show that S is subspace of L of S is equal to S. L of S is subspace of U over F. Already we know that. Why? Because linear span is subspace of U over F. L of S is nothing but S. So S is subspace of L of S is subspace of U over F. Therefore, S is subspace. Next, I am taking that L of S is equal to S. L of S is equal to L of S. L of S is nothing but S. So that is what L of S is equal to S. This thing over. Let V over F be a vector space. And S comma T or subspace of U over F. Then S subspace equal to T implies L of S subspace equal to L of T. L of S union T is equal to L of S plus L of T. I am taking that let U over F be vector space and S comma T or subspace of U over F. Let S is equal to I am taking here U1 U2 data so Um and Um T equal to I am taking that U1 U2 data Um and U1 plus 1 data Um. L of S is equal to gamma that equal to A1 U1 A2 U2 data AN Um. A is belongs to A. L of T equal to gamma 2 that equal to A1 A2 data AUM plus AM plus 1 UM plus 1 that equal to L of S. Right? So that means gamma 1 belongs to L of S and gamma 2 belongs to L of S. What can I show? I want to show that if S of S equal to T then L of S is equal to L of T. That means here I am taking S of S equal to B. So gamma 1 equal to you can write this. So, gamma 1 equal to what are A1, U1, A2, V2, data A and UM. Gamma 2 equal to, I am writing this, same thing, I am writing here, A1, U1, A2, U2, data A and UM, plus 0 times of UM plus 1, 0 times of AM plus 2, data. You can write here easily. This is element is span of L, so this element you can observe here, U1, U2, UM, data UM plus 1, UM plus 2, data UM, are the elements of T. Therefore, this is a linear combination of elements of T. I took that gamma belongs to L of T, L of S, I show that gamma belongs to L of T. Therefore, gamma belongs to L of S, which implies gamma belongs to L of T. Therefore, L of S is equal to L of T. So, first one is over. I want to show that S plus T is L of S plus T is equal to L of S plus L of T. S is equal to U1, U2, that is Um. T is equal to, I am taking V1, V2, where Vn. So, I am taking differently now here. S is equal to A1, U1, A2, U2, data AM, U1, V1, L of T is equal to V equal to B1, V1, data BM, VM, I'm taking differently here. S union T is equal to this, U1, U2, UM, and V1, V2, VM. L of S union equal to what happened? The linear combination of this element. That means gamma is equal to A1, U1, plus A2, U2, data AM, UM, and B1, V1, plus B2, V2, data BM, VM. This AI belongs to F and BS belongs to F. These are the AIs, comma, BIs are belongs to F. AIs and BIs belongs to F. L of S plus L of T is equal to what is this U plus V such that U belongs to L of S comma V belongs to L of T. This is my definition. Linear sum of two subspaces. L of S plus L of T equal to U plus V such that U belongs to L of S and V belongs to L of T. Yeah, let I am taking gamma belongs to L of S union T. Gamma I am taking, right? Gamma is equal to what is this A1 U1 plus data AM U1 plus B1 V1 plus data BM V1. This is nothing but this element linear combination of elements of S and linear combination of elements of T. That means gamma belongs to L of S plus gamma. Therefore, gamma belongs to L of S unit t, which implies gamma belongs to L of S plus L of t. Therefore, L of S unit t is also equal to L of S plus L of t. One is over. Now I am taking that x belongs to L of S plus L of t. I am taking x belongs to L of S plus L of t, which implies x is equal to u plus v. U nothing but a1 v1 plus a2 v2 divided as am v1. V nothing but b1 v1 plus b2 v2 divided as bn vn. Which implies that equal to what happened? It is a linear combination of S and t. It is a linear combination of S and t, right? S union t. That means x belongs to L of S union t. Therefore, x belongs to L of S plus L of t, which implies x belonging to L of S union t, which implies L of S plus L of t is equal to L of S union t. This is from 1 and 2, L of S plus L of t equal to L S union t. So, this end the lecture 7. So, thank you for watching this. So, okay. Thank you for watching this lecture.